Good morning, dear students, and welcome back for the online classes of English. Before proceeding with the new topic, let's have a quick revision of the previous one. So, dear children, in the previous class, we learned a poem, that is, Integrity Put to Test, written by John Gay. In this poem, we came to know about a young boy of school who was calm and serious in manner and was very honest. But due to his friend's continuous force of doing bad things, he too changed his mind and shared in the plunder with his friends. And what was that bad thing? To rob the neighbor's orchard, forgetting the apples. I hope you all understood the previous poem. Let's proceed with the new topic, lesson 2.1, an interesting observation. Let me tell you about the meaning of both interesting and observation. Interesting means if you find something that attracts your attention, for example, because you think it is exciting or unusual, or it grabs your interest, and then that thing or matter or term becomes interesting for you. In the same way, meaning of observation. Observation means it is something that you have learned by seeing or watching something and thinking about it. So, in this lesson, we will learn a mother and her baby's bondation and how a mother does all her work by holding her baby. Let's start with reading. An interesting observation. Have you ever observed closely how a mother holds her baby in her arms or against her body? Which of her two arms does she usually use while cradling her baby to sleep? Against which side, right or left of her chest? Does she press the baby to soothe it? And why? In which side of chest do you have your heart? So these are the questions related to this chapter. That have you ever observed closely how a mother holds her baby? Whether she holds the baby in her left arm or the right arm? And which two arms she usually use while cradling? Cradling means hold gently and rock from side to side. So, how she used to hold her baby while cradling to make her to sleep? And how she pressed the crying baby to soothe? So, all these are the questions. In which side you are having your heart, left or right? So, these all questions answer you will get at the end of the chapter. Okay? Let's start. Have you ever noticed how mothers usually hold their babies? Careful studies have disclosed the fact that 80% of mothers cradle their infants in their left arms, holding them against the left side of their bodies. One could say that it is because most people are right-handed. By holding their babies in the left arm, mothers keep their dominant arm free for their normal work. But a detailed analysis shows that this is not the case. Studies have shown that 83% of right-handed mothers hold the baby on the left side. But then so do 78% of left-handed mothers. In other words, only 22% of the left-handed mothers have their dominant hand. that is the left hand, free for normal work. Clearly, there must be some other reason why mothers prefer to hold their babies on the left side. So, dear children, it's given over here that careful studies have disclosed means revealed, that 80% of mothers cradle their infants in their left hand. Why they used to cradle? Cradle means, I just told you, hold gently and rock from side to side. So, it's given over here that 80% of mothers cradle their infants. Infants means a very young child or baby. So, they used to cradle their infants in their left arm because most of the work they used to do with their right arm. That's why they used to carry the baby against the right arm, that is towards the left arm. One could say that it is because most people are right-handed. That's what I told you just now, that most of the people are right-handed. Very few of them are left-handed. That's why they do all the household work and any of the other work with their right hand. That's why they used to hold the baby through the right, in place of right hand towards the left hand. By holding their babies in the left arm, mothers keep their dominant arm free for their normal work. Dominant, what do you mean by dominant? Having superior strength. That is your main arm. Like we people, like I am right-handed. So most of the work I used to do with my right hand. That's why, which will be my dominant arm? My dominant arm will be my right arm. Okay, that's why I hold my baby in my left side, not in my right side. Understood, children? That what is given over here, that by holding their babies in the left arm, mothers keep their dominant arm free for their normal work. But a detailed analysis shows that, analysis means examination. Okay, but a detailed analysis shows that this is not the case. Studies have shown that 83% of right-handed mothers hold the baby on the left side. So, how many percent? 83% of right-handed mothers hold the baby on the left side. But then, so do 78% of left-handed mothers. What they used to do? The left-handed mothers, they used to hold their babies towards the right hand. In other words, only 22% of the left-handed mothers have their dominant hand, that is the left hand. That is, only 22% of the left-handed mothers, and left-handed mothers, which will be their dominant hand? Will be their left hand, because they will be having more power. It is the superior one for them. So, 22% of left-handed mothers have their dominant hand, that is the left hand, free for normal work. Clearly, there must be some other reason why mothers prefer to hold their babies on the left side. And it is given over here that clearly there must be some other reason, because already the author told this is not the perfect reason. It is just case study. Okay. It is just a case study. Nobody is having full confidence on this case study. Okay, so that's what is given over here. There must be some other reason why mothers prefer to hold their babies on the left side. The only other clue comes from the fact that the heart is on the left side of the mother's body. Could it be that the sound of her heartbeat is the vital factor? It can be. Okay. Here it's given that the only other clue. Clue means fact or piece of evidence that helps to reveal the truth in an investigation. So what could be the other clue? That the fact, the heart is on the left side of the mother's body. The heart is on the left side of the mother's body. That's why most of the mothers, they used to hold their babies towards the left arm. Could it be that the sound of her heartbeat is the vital factor? Vital means utmost importance. So it can be. It's not confirmed, but it can be that the heartbeat sound is the utmost important factor. That's why most of the mothers, they used to hold their babies towards the left side rather than the right side. Next para. Perhaps during its existence, inside the body of the mother, the growing embryo becomes fixated on the sound of the heartbeat. If this is so, then the rediscovery of this familiar sound after birth might have a calming effect on the infant, especially as it has just been thrust into a strange and frighteningly new world outside. The mother, too, soon discovers unconsciously that her baby is more at peace if held on the left against her heart than on the right. So here it's given that perhaps during its existence means period of life. During the period of life, inside the body of the mother, the growing embryo. Embryo means what? Young baby before its birth. When the baby have not been taken birth in this world, before that they used to be in the womb of the mother. So that is known as embryo. Embryo means young baby before its birth. So here it's given that the growing embryo, the young baby before its birth, becomes fixated. Fixated means having an abnormal emotional attachment. Okay, having an abnormal emotional attachment. So before taking birth in this world, the mother and the baby through the embryo have a very strong connection. They have a very strong abnormal emotional attachment towards each other on the sound of the heartbeat. And if this is only the reason, if this is so, then the rediscovery of this familiar sound after birth might have a calming effect on the infant. Because when the baby is inside the embryo, at that time also the baby used to hear the sound of the heartbeat of his or her mother. Isn't it? So when the baby comes out in this world, at that time they are most familiar with the heartbeat sound of the mother. And that what is the thing which make a calming effect on the infant, especially as it has just been thrust into a strange and frighteningly new world outside. Because for the baby, this is when the baby used to come out, the world is strange for the baby, isn't it? And in a very frightening way, the baby used to come in this new world. The mother too soon discovers unconsciously means without realizing. The mother also discovers without realizing that her baby is more at peace. Why the baby is more at peace? If the baby used to be on the left against her heart, against the mother's heart, than on the right side. Next para. This may sound far-fetched, but tests have now revealed that it is nevertheless the true explanation. Groups of newborn babies in a hospital nursery were exposed for a considerable time to the recorded sound of heartbeat. This sound was at the standard rate of 72 beats per minute. There were 9 babies in each group, and it was found that most of them were crying for 60% of the time when the sound was not switched on. But this figure fell to only 38% when the heartbeat recording was being played. So what is given over here? This may sound far-fetched. Far-fetched means unlikely and unconvincing. Nobody can convince in this matter. But this may sound very unconvincing and unlikable. But tests have now revealed, as many tests have been going on taking by the scientists, by the doctors. So the tests have now revealed that nevertheless the true explanation. Groups of newborn babies in a hospital, in a nursery, groups of newborn babies were exposed. Exposed means left uncovered for a considerable time, for a particular time, the groups of newborn babies in a hospital, they have been recorded sound of heartbeat. How they have done, let's see. This sound was at the standard rate of 72 beats per minute. How many beats per minute? 72 beats per minute. There was 9 babies. How many babies were there? There were 9 babies in each group. And it was found that 60% of the babies were crying when the sound of heartbeat was off. They were not switched on. But as the heartbeat recording was being played, only 38% were there who were crying and rest all were at a suit of sleeping. Next para. The heartbeat groups also showed a greater weight again than the others. Although the amount of food was taken was the same in both cases, clearly the beatless groups were burning up a lot more energy as a result of their vigorous crying. So what's given over here? The heartbeat groups also showed a great weight gain. So what the heartbeat group showed? A greater weight gain than the others. Than the other any kind of matter, the heartbeat groups showed a greater weight gain towards the baby. Although the amount of food taken was same in both cases. Means where they were listening towards the sound of the heartbeat and where they were not listening towards the sound of the heartbeat. Both the group of babies, they were getting the same kind of food. But the place where the sound of the heartbeat was played, there the baby's weight gain was greater than the other place where the sound was not played. Clearly, the beatless groups were burning up a lot more energy as a result of their vigorous crying. Vigorous means strong crying, because they were not getting the heartbeat sound. So they were thinking that we are alone, we are not with our mother. That's why the beatless groups were burning a lot of energy. As you cry, as you walk, as you run, you used to burn up a lot energy, isn't it? So that's why the babies, they cannot walk, they cannot run, jump or laugh, isn't it? So what they used to do, they can only cry. So the strong cry of the babies, those who were not listening towards the recorded heartbeat, they were burning a lot more energy. Next para. Another test was done with slightly older infants at bedtime. In some groups, the room was silent. In others, recorded lullabies were played. In others, a ticking sound was operating at the heartbeat rate of 72 beats per minute. In still others, the heartbeat recording itself was played. It was then checked to see which groups fell asleep more quickly. The heartbeat group dropped off in half the time it took for any of the other groups. Then another test was done with slightly older infants. Earlier they have done a test with the newborn babies. Now they are doing a test with slightly older infants at bedtime. At bedtime means when they have to sleep. In some groups the room was silent. So they have decided that now they will be making separate rooms for the babies and a group of babies will be keep in those rooms. Like one room was silent, other room was recorded with lullabies. Lullabies, what is lullabies? gentle songs sung to make a child go to sleep. In Hindi, it is called as Lori Gana. Lori, I think you have understood, isn't it? So, lullabies means gentle songs sung to make a child to go to sleep. So, like that, they have prepared many rooms. And what they have done, let's see. In some groups, the room was silent. In others, recorded lullabies were played. In others, a ticking sound was operating at the heartbeat rate of 72 beats per minute. So, in one room, it was totally calm and quiet, silent. Then in one room, they kept a group of babies. There, the lullabies recorded was going on. And in one room, they made the same heartbeat rate of 72 beats per minute. That ticking sound was going in that room. In still others, the heartbeat recording itself was played. And in the fourth room, where the other group of babies were there, the heartbeat recording itself was played. The recording of the heartbeat was played. It was then checked to see which groups fell asleep more quickly, and then they were waiting to see that out of all these rooms where the group of babies are kept, in the silent room, in the recorded lullabies, in a ticking sound like the heartbeat of 72 beats per minute, and in the real heartbeat recording itself. They were waiting to check which room babies will sleep quickly. The heartbeat group dropped off. Dropped off means fell asleep. Fell asleep means they slept very fast. The heartbeat group dropped off in half the time it took for any of the other groups. So what they have done? The heartbeat group where the real recording of the heartbeat was played, that group was dropped off. That group fell asleep in the half time. They fell asleep in half the time it took for any of the other groups. So we'll finish this topic today over here. And I'll be continuing with the next part. In the next class. Okay, dear children. Till here I have explained you half the chapter. And half which is left out, that I am going to explain you in the next class. Thank you, children.